the Romans invaded, and the country of Gaulia became part of the Roman Empire. There's an emperor living somewhere across the sea in Rome, but still no king of England.
Eventually, the Romans left England because they were fed up with being attacked by pirates from Northern Europe. The pirates sought out their own territories. They were always squabbling and fighting each other, and gradually the strong territories got bigger and bigger, until there were only seven of them left within the whole country. Their leaders weren't too sure of it and started calling themselves kings, but they were only kings of their territory, such as Wessex.
But then, suddenly something happened that changed everything. Vikings from Norway, Denmark and Sweden then landed in England. They were faced more scared than anything that anyone had seen before. Pretty soon, they conquered half of England. In 858, the King of Wessex died and his son, Alfred the Great, was crowned. He defeated the Vikings and created a kingdom with fair laws. He was the first king of England.
Since Alfred the Great's time, whenever a king died, the crown passed to his son, brother, or some other member of his family. Harold Godwinson stopped all this in 1066. The King of England, Edward the Confessor, died. He did not leave any heirs to the throne.
The people of England found Harold Godwinson, King Harold II, on January 6, 1066, the day after King Edward died. However, there was another man who wanted to claim the English throne, and that was King Hardrada of Norway. When King Hardrada invaded England, and King Harold went to meet him in battle, William saw his chance. King Harold II defeated King Hardrada of Norway and turned south to face William.
Army, this way! This is your Hastings!
Captured the city of London. Shortly after, on December 25th, 1066, William was crowned King of England.
Not really. Oh well, I will put it back in my wallet.
most important part of the modern Burley Castle was the keep. It was built on a huge mound called the Mott. The sides of the Mott were so steep that it would have been impossible to run up in a long row. For added protection, a deep ditch was dug around the bottom of the Mott. At the bottom of the Mott was the Bailey. The Bailey buried inside for 1 to 3 acres. Inside the Bailey, the followers of the Lord who ran the castle. There were many buildings inside the Bailey, including stables, storehouses, workshops, kitchens, a chapel, and quarters for soldiers. A strong wooden fence called the palisade surrounded the Bailey.
All the conquerors of his own. He brought over 7 friends of the nations from the front of Hill. On the clever was Archbishop Lanfranc. He sent Normans all over England to find out who owned every castle, every house, every cottage, even every pig, and wrote it all down in a huge book. From this they worked out how much everyone should pay taxes. People hated this book. They thought it was dreadful as the end of the doom of the world would end, so they called it the Doomsday Book. William the Conqueror built over 1,000 Mottenbailey castles throughout England. Although Mottenbailey castles were quick to build, they could easily have been burned down, as they were made from wood. Durham Keep Castle was gradually replaced with many wooden castles, as they were stronger and harder for enemies to burn down. The main entertainment of the Great Hall was provided by musicians or by minstrels who played and sang. Sometimes the tables would be cleared away and people would dance.
Thank you.
been used for many things since it was first built. Hundreds of years ago, it was most famous as a prison, where some prisoners were even tortured or killed. The most famous people to be locked up in the Tower of London were Queen Elizabeth I and Guy Fawkes. The Tower of London housed the Royal Menagerie, the Royal Zoo. Over the years, the Tower has been home to a polar bear, used to go fishing in the River Thames, an elephant, lions and leopards. Now, it is just famous as the home of the Grand Jewels, which have been kept there since the year 1303.
The magnificent Windsor Castle in Berkshire is the oldest and largest occupied castle in the world. It has been the family home of British kings and queens for almost 1,000 years. The oldest parts of Windsor Castle were built by William the Conqueror.
Children and adults be outstanding for the national anthem. Sit down. I hope you enjoyed our assembly and thank you for coming.